Now let us discuss about ion selective electrode, which is called glass electrode. Ion selective electrode is also known as specific ion electrode. That means even though mixture of ions are there, it is selective or specific for one kind of electrons, one kind of ions. That is called ion selective electrode. The best example is glass electrode. Glass electrode is selective for H plus ions only. So even though mixture of ions are there, it will give the electrode potential of, this glass electrode will give the electrode potential of exclusively H plus ions, but not remaining. That's why it is called ion selective electrode. Most common application of glass electrode is for the determination of pH. It is used in the measurement of pH. pH electrode is an example of glass electrode, and it is selective for H plus ions only. So this glass electrode is selective for H plus ions only. And here is the construction of glass electrode. Glass electrode is constructed by taking inside electrical contact is made by taking silver wire. The silver wire is in contact with silver chloride. Silver coated with silver chloride, this total device is made for the electrical contact. Inside this we filled saturated, So inside we filled with 0.1 molar HCl solution. 0.1 molar HCl solution is the electrolytic solution in case of this glass electrode. And we have two basic parts in this. One is glass tube, second is called glass bulb. This vertical device is called a glass tube. So here the edge of this region, this is glass bulb, which is made up of a special type of glass called Corning glass. Corning glass is selective for the diffusion of H plus ions only. Hence it is able to give the reduction potential, selective potential for H plus ions only. Corning glass is made up of oxides of sodium, silicon, those oxides are used to construct this glass bulb. It is selective for the diffusion of H plus ions only. This is about the construction of glass electrode. What we are taking? Electrical contact is made by taking silver coated with silver chloride. Inside the bulb, totally we are filling 0.1 molar HCl solution. Here we have two parts, the glass tube and bulb. Glass tube is very common type of glass, but glass bulb is made up of special type of glass, which is called Corning glass. This Corning glass having very small cavities or pores, which is selective for the diffusion of H plus ions only. This is about the construction. Now let us see the chemical reaction involved in the glass electrode. Glass membrane having terminal sodium ions on its surface, it able to exchange H plus ions. That's the reason why after the exchange, it is converted into glass membrane with H plus by releasing Na plus ions into the solution. How can we construct this glass electrode? Just to be sadha apparatus, same can be described here. Glass tube ended with glass bulb or glass bubble. Both are same. So this is about the typical instrumentation of glass electrode. Inside the electrode, usually we filled a buffer solution, and silver wire is there, which is covered with silver chloride. So which is immersed in the pH of internal solution. For example, 0.1 molar HCl solution was taken, and buffer solution is also added in order to maintain the constant pH value inside. Okay, so this is about construction of glass electrode. Active part of this electrode is glass bubble. At the end, we have that circular part, which is called glass bubble. So this glass tube is strong and thick walls will be there, but glass bulb is made up of very thin and porous material. A special type of glass called Corning glass is used for the construction of that one. It is composed of oxides of silicon, magnesium and sodium. Surface of the glass is protonated by internal external solution. Protonated internal inside as well as outside. That's the reason why equilibrium is achieved in between out and inside H plus ions. both the sides of glass electrodes are charged by protons. This type of diffusion is mainly responsible to deliver to generate potential difference. Diffusion of HNS ions to the glass bulb is mainly responsible to generate electrode potential in this glass electrode. Half cell notation for glass electrode is represented as silver metal is in contact with silver chloride. So both are solids only. So this is mainly used for the electrical contact. And inside the glass bulb, we filled 0.1 molar HCl solution. This is the electrolytic solution filled in that. And the glass membrane is there at the bottom of glass electrode. That is the main and important part. This total composition is called the half cell notation for this glass electrode. Now, let us apply this Nernst equation. Glass electrode electrode potential is equal to E naught glass plus 0.0591 pH. So this is the common equation for pH determination, which is already derived in case of twin hydrogen electrode. And EMF of the cell is given by potential difference. Potential difference is nothing but E cathode minus E anode. Here, always glass electrode is in contact with another electrode. That another electrode is columnar. Hence, cathode electrode will be taken as a columnar electrode whose electrode potential is standard, that is 0.2422. Anode electrode is a glass electrode. That glass electrode potential is given here. Let us substitute this E anode value with this E naught plus 0.0591 pH. EMF of the cell is equal to, this is 0.2422 is the electrode potential of columnar minus E naught plus 0.0591 pH. This is the total value of glass electrode potential. Now, equation is concised as, so 0.0591 pH, we can take this term towards left hand side. 0.0591 pH is equal to 0.2422 minus E naught minus EMF will be there. When 0.0591 pH is equal to, this total term is there, then pH is equal to 0.2422 minus E naught minus EMF by, here we have 0.0591, it will come as denominator by 0.0591. So this is the final equation for the determination of pH of the solution. pH is equal to 0.2422 minus E naught minus EMF by 0.059. This is about Nernst equation for glass electrode. Now let us see how can we apply this glass electrode in our daily life. Glass electrodes are commonly used pH measurement, which ranges from 0 to 10 pH. It is a wide range compared to that twin hydrogen electrode. Twin hydrogen electrode operated up to 8.5 ppm only. Plus, but glass electrode is working till pH 10. Glass electrode have utilized in the wide range of applications, including pure research, control of industrial process, analytical analysis of food materials, even in the cosmetics, this glass electrode applications are there. Wherever pH measurement is required, there we can apply this glass electrode because it is able to give accurate, robust values. Measurement of environmental indicators. Any pH changes are observed in the environment. In that case also, we can apply this glass electrode. And micro electrode measurements such as cell membranes, electrical potentials and soil acidity can be determined by using this glass electrode. It can be constructed easily, very simple, and equilibrium is very rapidly achieved. Very accurate results are obtained by this glass electrode. It is not easily poisoned by the addition of any kind of impurities in that. These are the major advantages and applications of glass electrode. Now let us see what is the limitation of this one. Glass electrode should be operated in the range of 0 to 10 pH only. More than that, we can't operate this one. And what normal potentiometer is not sufficient for glass electrode. We need electronic potentiometer, then only pH determination is accurate with this glass electrode? And any turbidity present in the water or electrolytic solution that will turbidity in electrolyte will close the sieves, close the pores. So in case of this also it is not working. So turbidity present in electrolyte also used to obstruct the functioning of this glass electrode. This is about glass electrode. Let us recall about this glass electrode. Glass electrode is the example of ion selective electrode. It is selective for the diffusion or electrode potential of only H plus ions. Glass electrode have two important parts. One is glass bulb, second is glass tube. Glass tube is the normal glass only. But glass bulb present at the bottom, that is responsible for electrode potential. At the bottom we have glass bulb that is made up of Corning glass. The Corning glass is the oxides of sodium, magnesium and silicon. And inside a glass tube we have silver metal which is in contact with silver chloride, that is used to make the electrical contact. And electrolyte field in that is 0.1 molar HCl solution. And the total device now connected to another columnar electrode. So because this glass electrode is working like an anodic compartment. And this used to generate oxidation potential, because here Na plus ions present in the glass membrane, which can be replaced by H plus ions from that electrolyte. Because of H plus ion diffusion, electrode potential is generated here. And cell notation for glass electrode is represented as silver chloride followed by what we have? Silver chloride followed by 0.1 molar HCl solution followed by glass membrane. This is about the composition of half cell notation for this.